Hi, I'm Suhali Khan.
Hi, I'm Anya Singh.
And you're watching
Awesome.
Hi, I'm Surbhi. How are you?
I'm good, I think. I have a little bit of a sniffle and I'm imagining lots of body aches, but I think I'm okay.
Okay.
It's over video calls, like through the phone. Okay. So a bit nervous.
So firstly, you know, I think so we are three sisters in real life, so I could really relate a lot with Kaun Banegi Shikharvati, because, well, you know, I mean, fights between sisters is something which is not uncommon in India. Well, it is what actually happens. So firstly, it's very, very relatable, but what is not is of course it's not relatable with me, but it is of course to Soha, because I think, you know, many times when we talk to especially actors, you know, they say ki hame life mein ye banna tha, hame life mein wo banna tha, isliye ab actor ban gaye, you know, so that we can play a lot of roles. Like, we can be a doctor, we can be a policeman, we can be so many things.
But I mean, you don't actually become a doctor by playing a doctor, no? You can't actually go around and do surgeries on people.
Yeah, but then they can wear those coats and, you know,
wow, like, okay. Yeah, and Halloween also for that.
Yes. So Soha, here, you know, you are actually playing a princess, you know, which you are in real life. But I would want to know that, you know, not many people know that, you know, I mean, the way we are as Indians are brought up, you know, not every day are you reminded of being a princess, you know, it's just a normal way of you, you know, being, you know, like brought up in the, like, childhood. But when was that one moment when you actually realized that, oh my God, I'm a princess?
I think, you know, my mother tells me that the first time blood was drawn from my arm and I saw that it was red and not blue, I cried. But I said, what? My blood is not blue? And I was genuinely upset. And I thought, ki mere saath dhoka hua hai. So that was the time when I realized that all this princess stuff, at the end of the day, I think we all have the same blood running in our veins. And, you know, Anya and I are pretty much the same. Shocking as yes. It may seem. But, you know, I do feel privileged for just the richness, which every family obviously has legacy and stories, yeah, of, you know, what our ancestors have done. But I feel that our stories are quite rich and, you know, they go back a long time. And there's a lot that we can learn also, you know, good and bad, from that past. But the most important thing also as a student of history that I've learned is that if you want to be relevant, you must adapt to what is the future and what is happening around you. You can't remain in the past. Then you become irrelevant.
Okay. Yes. Yes. Anya, you know, your character, you know, I mean, correct me if I'm wrong. What I could understand from the trailer is that, you know, she's a little rebellious. You know, all four sisters are very, very different, you know, like really very different. So yeah. Anya is someone who's very rebellious, you know, like she's so much into games. Like, this is what I could understand from the trailer. How much of Uma Shikharvati are you in real life? Are you mischievous? Are you naughty? How are you in real life?
I think I'm pretty mischievous. I like to believe, but I'm somebody who likes to amuse myself, you know. So my mischief is not shady or like conniving mischief. It's very like, oh, I just want to have fun and entertain myself sort of mischief. And okay, that way, I wouldn't say yes, to an extent, of course, Uma is rebellious, as are all the sisters at this point in time, because they don't agree with what their father is saying or with each other. And they're all trying to prove a point. But Uma is rebellious in a more subtle manner, because she's extremely underconfident as a person, of herself, of her game, of whatever she's doing. So it's not in your face. She's the quieter, the meeker one who's trying to like stand up for herself. Sometimes it backfires, sometimes it works. So you see Uma kind of grow, you know, through the episodes.
Soha, on social media, you know, we see that Inaya and Kunal share a very, very adorable relationship, you know, like, just like my sister and my father, she's an out and out daddy's girl. It seems like that, you know, like, there's some super adorable pictures. The first pictures with you and pictures of her own, like, Inaya's pictures are super cute, but there's something so magical, you know, when Kunal and Inaya are together, you know, like, we feel that and we love and we really wait for those pictures to get uploaded on the net.
But, yeah, I'm not feeling jealous at all by this.
Yeah, that's
that's what is my question.
What is your question?
You know? Yeah, my question is that only, you know, because mothers usually aisa hota hai na, they usually say that, you know, tumko 9 mahine kokh mein pala, and you know, and sab kuch father ka, naam bhi father ka, you know, like you also look like your father, you know, like many mothers I usually see saying that.
So are you trying to make me feel bad now, or is there a question in this?
I'm trying to ask you, you know, if you ever feel jealous, you know, by seeing that, you know, she's out and out daddy's girl, and you know, her beautiful bond with Kunal.
No, actually, it makes me happy. I really do feel parenting is not something that you can do solo, and you know, the personality that Kunal has is something that I don't. We're very different as people, yes. And I see how important it is to have that personality around my child, and how she benefits from him just being who he is, even if that means that he's less patient than me, even if that means that, you know, he wants to tickle her as soon as she's had dinner, and I'm like, don't hang her upside down, she's just, I just fed her that meal, even if, you know, like whatever, like I read stories to her, he from books, and he invents the stories from his mind, and you know, we have very different approaches to parenting. But I do think that that's important, and I really enjoy in a similar way that you do. I really enjoy watching them together. And even though there are times when I'm tokoing him and saying "aise mat karo, aise mat karo, aise mat karo," so many times, you know, where he's just like, "Listen, let me. I also am a parent. Let me do what I want to do with her. She's also my daughter." And I'm like, "But maine sara kaam to maine kiya, aur jo sare matlab sulane ka kaam, khilane ka kaam main karti hu." So you feel like you have more of a huck, but it's not the case, you know. And as much more time that I spend with Inaya, if you ask her also, you know, ridiculous questions like, you know, are you missing me? I'll ask her, or are you, you know, how much do you love me or something? She'd always say, you and Papa, you and Papa. So she loves him unconditionally. And I think that that's a really good place to be in. Yeah. Where I want her to love me more because, you know, I'm around more because of the fact that, you know, I'm not working as much as Kunal is. You know, I'm doing certain things. I like the fact that she really has a genuine connection.
Yeah, she does. I mean, it actually, you know, speaks volumes by the pictures. You know.
I spent time at the house and I have never seen parents that are just so doting and ready to do whatever for their child. So I remember it was Sound of Music that she was obsessing over in the middle. And before she goes to bed, Soha, Kunal and her fully perform this song, you know? And you know, she'll bend and she'll be like, but you have to kick me, or like, oh, this girl. And they fully pretend to be these characters. Not just sitting there. Just...
But that's because otherwise there'll be a meltdown before bedtime and it'll only affect us. So if you do everything that way, then at least bedtime becomes peaceful.
Wow.
Really treat her like an adult, which is what I find so fascinating, because if you speak to Inaya, you don't think you're speaking to a four-year-old girl, and at that point she was a three-year-old child. And you know, sometimes she'd say things like, there was lightning one night, and she's like, don't worry Anya, it's only music of the sky. And I was just like, what?
Wow.
This is really interesting thing, and I genuinely really enjoy talking to this child.
Yeah.
Wow. I love that lightning part. Wow. That's so good. I never thought it that way. So, yeah. Anya, so we were at the trailer launch as well, you know, and we got to know that all the actors, I mean, were scared or intimidated by Lara Dutta because of a prank. You know, why was it like?
You know, Lara is someone who commands respect. That's just her personality and aura, you know. So when you're around her, inevitably, because she is a very strong personality, she's as normal and crazy as us, but for some odd reason there was always that I would never cross that line with her, whether it was a joke, whether it was just anything. I wasn't initially intimidated, but after that it was just out of respect that just comes with this aura that she has. And I would love to have that. I'm just a pushover.
Yeah, like for the longest time, Anya would call her Lara Dutta ma'am.
Yeah, that's like, what she said.
Why aren't you calling me Soha ma'am? Because I was not Soha ma'am for more than 1 minute.
Yeah.
If even it's that.
Lara ma'am, because Soha is just like, just look at her. I mean, the way she speaks to me and the things she says to me, I just can't. I can't take her seriously sometimes.
Soha, you know, there's a thing, you know, like first siblings, second competition between siblings, and then, you know, if they are in the same industry, there's always some competition. Like when we were in school, I mean, parents used to always compare ki tumhari dekho tumhari behan kitne marks aaye the tumhare itne kyun nahi aaye. So when you're in the same industry, you know, many times knowingly or unknowingly you do get compared. So was there any just like here in Kaun Banegi Chakravarti, there is a huge tussle, you know, between the four sisters. Was there any tussle at home between you and Saif, sir?
You know, no, because I was that person who is there saying, "Dekho, iske kitne achhe marks mile." I was that person because I was the only one who went to university and did well academically.
Yes.
So I felt that, you know, everybody has a strength of their own, and if you can discover what your strength is, and if you can, you know, draw confidence from that and not compare yourself to others. That's where true contentment and happiness lies. And of course, a lot of the damage comes from parenting, as well as a lot of the strength can come from good parenting. And I was very fortunate to have two parents that were huge achievers in their own rights. I mean, they scaled the heights of their chosen professions. And yet there was never any pressure for us to do the same at all. To excel at all. In fact, my father always said, you know, the goal in life is to be happy, presumably. And so you do what makes you happy. Of course, at the age of 18, he was also very keen that we be independent and that we live on our own and that we earn our own money. And those values were clearly taught to us, that we have to have professions and we have to earn our way. But apart from that, he said, you know, I've given you all a good education. Now go and use it and, you know, make your own choices. And we're there to pick you up and we're there certainly to guide you. But I'm not going to tell you what to do. And there was no pressure, as I said, to excel. Of course, once I joined the industry, more than being compared to my brother, I found myself being compared to my mother because we're both women, perhaps. Yeah. And I remember my first review when it came out, it said she looks like her mother, but she acts like her father. And my father was like, is that a compliment? It doesn't seem appear to be a compliment. But I don't know why, because I'm a pretty decent actor. And I was like, oh, I don't even know what that means. So I think if you have a jhalak of a parent and if you enter a visual profession like this, there will be more comparisons to your mother or a previous generation because you're not competing for the same roles with a male sibling.
So it's called Awesome Shots, where we ask 7 questions and we expect honest and quick answers. I'll ask
a question. Whatever you want.
So I'll ask a question and then first Soha can answer and then Anya can answer. Okay. Sure. So first question is, what is the weirdest superstition you believe in?
I don't believe in superstitions. I do that. It's not weird, but I do that thu-thu-thu nazar na lage. I do spit a lot on people that I love.
Anya's expression.
even I do this touch wood a lot. And I think a black cat crossing my path, because I remember a black cat crossing, I never believed in this. And then a whole bottle of Coke spilled it on me. So after that, I was just like, maybe.
Okay. My next question is very much similar to what you answered just now. Most embarrassing moment till date?
Too many. I have way too many.
I also have a few, but I remember mine was like, I think the first time I was walking on Lakme Fashion Week. And it was a bridal show for Vikram Fadnis. And they put that, you know, mehndi on your hands that is like an ink mehndi. And just before going on stage, I was like dabbing my upper lip. And when I went on stage, I had like a henna mustache. That was definitely. And like, I mean, if you search like Soha henna mustache or something, like I will find you this picture.
Most embarrassing, I can't particularly remember, but I remember this one time. So I was in a boarding school and I was in a girls' boarding school, and twice in a year, the boys' school would also come. So this was fate time and the boys' school came. And I was casually, you know, being cool and walking, and I tripped over this rope and I fell and my entire skirt went up onto my head. So that was not nice at all.
When was your first heartbreak?
It's yet to happen. I've broken a few hearts, but I'm trying to think genuinely. I think I've broken more hearts than I've had my heart broken, which is also like quite heartbreaking if you think about it, but one doesn't get so much sympathy. It's hard to break hearts also.
My first heart, I was 21.
Which Bollywood celebrity do you think is overrated?
Is overrated?
I do, Rama.
Yes.
Don't fall for that, don't answer it.
Soha.
I'm bad. Are you saying me? I'm overrated.
I'd rather take your name than take anyone's name.
Okay, then Anya, highly overrated.
Have you ever stolen anything from the set or from the hotel? Of course, not shampoo bottles.
I will tell you, there was a bathrobe and it was kind of like, am I allowed to take the bathrobe or not in a hotel? And then I took the bathrobe and then it went all the way down and I was leaving and it was in my bag. And then at reception, I had a change of heart and I said, the bathrobe, can I buy it? And they said the bathrobes are not for sale. So then I returned it.
So you almost...
It was a really nice bathrobe.
I've bathroom slippers from hotels because my dogs love to do them. So it's actually like a return present for them. And from set, I've always asked and taken...
clothes.
Yeah. Imagine taking like artifacts and furniture and being like...
What is the meanest thing you've heard about yourself?
Wow, I don't pay attention to mean things, but my height. People are really mean about my height. Like I'm always called short. Yeah.
I'm not short a lot too, but I just thought that never taken that out.
Yeah, I mean, I think I'm the same height, but then I always very proudly say that I have average Indian woman height because I googled it and I found that 5'2 is average Indian woman height.
Yeah, I'm 5'2.
Yeah, so my last question to you, 3 reasons why people should watch Kaun Banegi Shikharpati on Z5.
It is a very talented cast, a really unusual setting and a genuinely funny, entertaining show.
I will just add to that and say it's as bizarre as it can get. It's a well-written show and visually beautiful.
Okay. So really, really excited. And it's very relatable, as I said, that, you know, I mean, 4 sisters, we are 3, but 4. And I'm sure people would love it and can't wait to watch it. Thank you so much.
Thank you. Thank you for the fun interview.
Thank you so much. Oh my God. I'm glad.